Hi and welcome. For this project I needed some old books, so I actually got mine from a recycling centre, or you could try a second-hand bookshop. For this project I needed some hardback books which would be more sturdy and not so flexible as paperbacks can be. I had a range of sizes from quite large to like a medium size hardback books. The subject matter doesn't matter because that's not what it's about. We're going to be just using the shape and not the contents. As you can see, there's quite a variety of books here. I laid out these in the design I wanted, temporarily held together with masking tape to make some cutting marks. The next stage is to try to cut through these books all together if possible. A handsaw seemed like a good idea at the time, but as I was trying to cut through, they were all moving and going a bit out of alignment, so I had to take another approach. So back to square one and take them apart and try another way. This time I used an electric saw and it worked a treat. It went through really well and very neat, but please take care with these sort of tools as you'll end up losing your hand. As you can see from these photographs, they're a lot more neatly cut and a lot more precise, which is good. The next stage was to separate the books, then start working on the water pattern. This was a bit of a tryout, this picture here. The centerpiece was cut out using the scalpel and doing layer pages at a time. Once again, with scalpels, also be careful. In this picture here, you can see where the covers have been removed from where the cuts were, and how it's starting to look with the bottom layer showing where I've just scalped out some of the water texture for the bottom. I had to remove some of the pages from the middle of the underneath of each book to give the effect of it drooping downwards, so it wouldn't get the downwards flow for a waterfall. They would just sit on top of each other. So this, with no underneath, the pages would naturally drop downwards. Here I worked on one book at a time, cutting out with a scalpel layers of pages, gradually forming like a rock bed at the back of the waterfall, so that when strands of water were put on later, they'd have something to bounce off and sort of sit on. The gaps between the books are quite interesting, and they sort of make natural nooks and crannies and gives a little wonder to what's actually going on in there. Now I think you can see things are starting to take shape. The tree at the top of the waterfall is actually a reasonable sort of twig, quite a dried out one from my garden. Next I took some old pages from a very old book with just letters and writing on, and I dipped these strips of paper into some PVA glue and wrap them around the tree trunk to give it more of a fantastic fantasy sort of feel. At this stage I've glued all the books together, but keeping the pages in the very center still loose. To keep the tree in place, I've actually drilled into the top book and pushed the tree right into it. This makes it really stable. Here is the tryout of how I was actually going to do the water. I cut strips of the old book that I used for the tree to try and get it to flow downwards, but it's getting there, but I'm not quite happy with this yet. Here I have obliterated the original colour of the books and the covers. This is really a ground for the paint effect I'm going to put on this shortly. I've added in a few false bookmarks. There were a few, but I've just added in a couple more just to give it an extra dimension around the sides. I've added extra wire to the tree and papered it with the strips of paper again, and cut out some small leaves and like some trailing vines. It's a bit of a laborious task, but I think it's going to be worth it. More leaves, more vines, keep going. I've started to add some colour. I wanted something sort of natural, so I've chosen like a marbly kind of pattern with like yellow ochres and browns, but not obliterating the white that I've put on already. And here I've used a sword liner brush in a very wet sort of mix, so you can do very long lines with the sword liner brush. It's got very long hairs. With marble you don't really want to cross the lines over too much, not the same colour anyway. There is a little bit of toothbrush splatter here and there, just for some extra sort of spray effects. I've glued a few pieces of cardboard at the bottom of the tree to give it a little bit more height around the base of the tree, so that it's not just totally flat at the top of the books. The water effects finally come together. What I've done is I've got some of the very old pages again, and use the translucent pearlescent wash, let this dry, and then slice the pages up, but keeping the pages held together by a strip, and then slide it into the rock carvings that I did earlier. I think this works relatively well. I've curled them underneath as they're going down as well, and I've also got some little gems, little like plastic droplets, which I've glued on there to give a wet look. I'm not sure if you can actually see it in this picture, but there are lots of tiny little droplets giving it a sort of wet feel. I also added these little droplets to the ends of the vines, which help them hang nicely, and they actually move in if there's a little breeze going past, which is nice. And yes, it links the tree with the waterfall nicely. It's like an ever-circling cycle of water, like droplets dropping down onto the waterfall. I've added some more detail to the base of the tree, and there's also the odd little butterfly here and there on the tree. Some extra foliage and plant life around the tree to make it not feel alone. I've added a pond to the bottom of the waterfall because it had to go to somewhere. I used a mirror, which I've fixed onto some plywood, and I've decorated the wood surround with the same paper that's on the top of the waterfall, and added the droplets again, so it's all got a kind of unison. And it's got its own full cycle now of water movement. I've added a few extra false roots just at the side to make it look like the tree is going down through the books too, just for an extra added touch. Well, that's it from me. I hope you like it, and take care. Bye bye.